when a mime seems to peek over a wall or tug a rope, you get a pretty vivid impression of the object that the mime is interacting with. And what we wanted to know is what your mind is doing to give you that kind of experience. Pat and I are both pretty terrible mimes. And so we chose a higher tech solution, which was interacting with a real object and then digitally removing it. The subjects would look at the person interact with a wall or a box, and then a line would appear on the screen, either a vertical line or a horizontal line. The subject's job was actually just to totally ignore the behavior of the actor and just tell us as quickly as they could what the orientation of the line was. If a vertical line appears right after the man interacts with the wall, you find it very easy to say that the line is vertical because it matches the interaction you just saw. But if you first see the man step on a box and then a vertical line appears, it kind of throws you off. We were able to measure how much better they were at answering what the orientation of the line was when it matched the interaction that they had just seen, and then how much slower they were when it didn't match. There are many processes in our minds that happen whether you try to do them or not. And reading turns out to be something like that.
If you're looking at words, it's hard not to read them. So I'm going to show you the word blue, but it's written in red ink. And then I'm going to ask you to tell me what is the name of the color of the ink, not the name of the word that I'm actually showing you. People try to say red, but they can't help but read the word blue, and it slows them down a little bit. The Stroop effect is that our response times are slower when there's a mismatch.
Just like in the Stroop effect, you can't help but be biased by the interaction you've just seen. So people are faster to say that the line is vertical if it matches the orientation of the surface that the man just interacted with.
Mimes are interacting with a very basic part of our processing. And so if a mime wants to convince us that they're doing something realistic, they have to be really, really good at what they're doing in order to trick that part of our minds.